Today we would like to present you Mr. Adolivio Capece, a well-known chess journalist. He is also an Italian chess master, but also a freelancer journalist in general. Mr. Capece is also chief redactor of one of the oldest chess magazines in the world, called Italia Scacchistica. This chess magazine celebrates this year 100 years of its foundation.
Yes, l'Italia Scacchistica is one of the ancient magazines of chess in the world. It was founded in 1911 by Marquis Stefano Vosselli del Turco in Florence. And after the Second World, the redaction came in Milano, and now the magazine has got its first centenary. I am the editor, and not a centenary, I am the editor since 1992, and I am very happy to have got this goal. And if I can, this is the cover of the first number of the century, and it is the number 1214 in absolute in the history of the magazine.
You arrived yesterday. Did you have enough time to get impressions about this championship?
Oh yes, the championship, by the technical point of view, is really very, very strong, and is really wonderful for a chess player to see the so many people, so many players, so many good players, grandmasters, and so on. The playroom is also very comfortable, and I think that the Croatia made another wonderful step to promote chess around the world.
How your impressions about Italian players? They are in number 27, 22 men and 5 women, and for the first time among Italian players there is one priest.
Yes, the priest, not officially, represents Vaticano. I said not officially because Vaticano is not yet a federation of the FIDE, the International Chess Federation, but we hope that very early also Vaticano can reach the great family of chess. About our players, well, our hope are on Fabiano Caruana, that is a young grandmaster, about number 50 in the world, and we hope that he can be among the first and at least qualify for the World Cup. But we have also many girls who are very, very strong. The first of them is Elena Sedina, but we have also a young girl, 16 years old, Marina Brunello, who is international women master, and she is the first in Italy to get the title. To be serious, she is the second, but the first was Clavice Benini, owing to the second place in the World Female Championship in 1937, behind the famous Menchik, Vera Menchik. So Marina Brunello is the first girl to reach the title after the Second World War.
Thank you for so many informations about Italian chess.
Thank you.
Now we will make a small experiment. I will give a microphone to my friend Adolivio Capece, and then he will try to make an interview with me.
Okay, sorry for my English, it's not so good, but in any case, Micio Cebalo is a grandmaster well known all over the world, I think, especially this year, because he won the Senior World Championship. It is to say, the World Championship for people who is over 60. But I think that he was very happy of this victory.
Of course, I was very happy. In a way, I managed to crown my whole chess career. Not because I had a feeling that I have to prove something to someone anymore, but because I managed to prove to myself that I'm still capable of winning such a strong tournament.
And it was really a strong tournament. And now we have again in Italy in October, and I hope that Mr. Grandmaster Cebalo can repeat the confirm his title. But now, please, let us know what is your role here in Rijeka in this tournament.
Here I'm an official commentator for the internet page of this tournament. This is not for the first time that I'm doing such a job. I used to be three times official commentator in three Olympiads. It was Novi Sad 1990. It was in Bled in Slovenia in 2002. And it was in Torino in 2006. I was also official commentator in European Championship in Budva last year. And we made together a press center in Saint Vincent, you remember, I hope, for a European Club Cup.
Okay, and now the last question. I reverse the question. What do you think about this tournament and what are you feeling about it?
I'm very satisfied with the organization since I was the part of it and I'm still the part of it. Of course, I regret a lot that I'm not able to play, but I just have too many things to do and it wouldn't be easy to play in such circumstances. I hope that with this championship, Rijeka will enter definitely in chess map for future, and that we will have a possibility to organize more important chess events in this place.
Okay, so thanks so much to Grandmaster Mišo Cevalo, and thanks to all.
Thank you.